Hi friends, welcome back. I am sorry this video has taken so long to upload. The first few weeks of school have been super busy, and I also discovered that I hate editing YouTube videos. So this is going to be a long one, and it's been a long time coming, long time in the making, and I don't know if I'm going to post this long of videos anymore because it takes me so long to edit, and that is my least favorite part. So I'm going to show you guys a little desk upgrade that I did at the beginning of the semester, which was 2 weeks ago. We are now starting on week 3, so it's been a bit, but check it out. All right, friends, so here is a little pre-upgrade desk tour. My pink chair came from Target. It's pretty comfy. Underneath, I have an outlet extender so I can get some more things plugged in than just two things. The little black footstool is to hold my feet up to help my back. This lamp came from Amazon. It's pretty nice. It's got different light settings. Press and hold to turn off. Press again to turn on. And I can also change the light like to warm, white light, and so on. It's also very adjustable on the top. Can go up and down and twist the light as well to be out of my face. There's my laptop. I have my pink mouse pad, my black Apple mouse, which I love, is wireless. Underneath I have my textbooks, all my pens and pencils, my sticky notes, my little cute stapler, and I also have this file little file drawer that holds loose papers that don't go in my notebook. Underneath, I have just a little cubby that holds random things for school. I also have a three-hole punch that I use to put things in my binder and my laptop case underneath. And that is my desk tour. Like I mentioned in my last video, I am a full-time student right now, and due to COVID, I am working completely from home, and I should have done this a lot sooner. I've been working on my tiny little 13-inch laptop all since last March, which was the end of spring semester of last year, and then all of fall semester now of last year, so of 2020, and I should have, like I said, gotten this set up at the beginning of fall semester. It's just so hard to focus on my tiny laptop. And usually when I'm on Zoom, I have to be paying attention to Zoom with all the PowerPoints, as well as having something else up for my notes. So usually I'm having like a split screen on my MacBook, which on a 13-inch screen is really small for each thing. And usually you can't even see all of the material that you're supposed to see. So I decided to get a new setup for myself. I ordered a monitor so I can have my laptop and a monitor so I can have essentially like a bigger split screen. And I got, what else did I get? I got a laptop holder, and then I got a new Apple keyboard to actually match my Apple mouse that is the best. So I'm gonna do a little bit unboxing here. This is the laptop or the monitor. It came by itself. And I know there is actually one thing in this box that doesn't have to do with my desk. And I will explain that since it came in the same package. And explain that to you guys. So also, Amazon's tape, I mentioned this to Matthew last night, doesn't even stick. It came like this. I picked it up at the door and it wasn't even stuck. So that's nice. Somebody probably could have taken my stuff. So I don't even know what the point of cutting it is. But here we go. All right. Okay, so this first thing, like I said, doesn't relate to my desk. but last week I flew home, which is Washington State, as most of you know. And when I fly home, I do my best to see as many doctors as I can that I need to while I'm home. And I go in for a yearly eye appointment. And I went in, and these are actually new glasses that I got yesterday in the mail. And I told my eye doctor that my right eye, I've noticed that later in the day, will tend to get this little spot where it feels like something is almost like stuck in my eye, or like I have a scratch, and it's hard for me. I mean, it's not hard, but it's harder to close my eye and it feels a little bit irritated. And he told me, fun fact that I didn't know, that if you take some kind of heating pad that can stay hot for a good amount of time, and you put it on your eyes every night for like 10 to 15 minutes, and he said it has to be pretty warm. He said a washcloth won't suffice just because those cool off so quickly. But he said if you put this on your eyeballs, your eyelids, obviously, for like 10 to 15 minutes a night, it will actually make the natural oils in your eyes come out more, or however you'd say it. Your eyes will be more lubricated, for lack of a better word. So I ordered this professional eye shield. It's Kimku. Not really sure. From Amazon, I picked the one with the best ratings. So it's microwave activated, antibacterial, washable, and reusable, and it's non-allergenic. So I'm really interested to see. It's really soft. It's actually like velvet. Mmm. It's got this little strap with Velcro. So essentially I'll be able to heat this up in the microwave and then put it over my eyes and get those natural eye oils coming out. So I will probably try that tonight, and I can let you guys know how it works if any of you have the same issue. I don't know if I'm just weird. And it came with a little instruction sheet that I'm not going to read right now. All right, so that is the only thing in this box that is not related to my desk setup. So moving on. All right. So what I'm most excited for is this handy dandy magic keyboard. Like I said, it's the Apple keyboard. I'm pretty excited for this. So let's open it up. And something that I don't appreciate from Apple is any of their products that are this color, like the gray or black, they actually charge more for. So I've heard it's because this is a harder color to get. I don't know if that's really true. If any of you more educated people know about that, let me know. Let's see here. I just don't really like the silver stuff. I like the steel gray. I feel like it's more subtle. Looks less cheap, I guess. Okay. Also, this is always really hard to get off. So it's cool because this one is the Magic Keyboard with the numeric keypad. So instead of having to type, not that I'm an accountant or anything, but instead of having to type numbers on the top bar like my MacBook I have now, I'll have a little number keypad on the side. So that's kind of cool. Ooh, here it is. Wow. So it's covered in this plastic. Ooh, that is such a good sound. All right. Whoa. Wow, it is very low profile. Here's the box. Comes with the little charger. That could be used for my iPhone. Wow. And the little instructions. So I'm gonna close this bad boy back up. Put that down here. Alrighty. So I'm not really sure. I should read the instructions. I'm not really sure if you have to charge this. Rechargeable battery and uses Bluetooth technology to connect wirelessly to your Mac. So it looks like. So there's the port for the charger. And then that tiny little on-off switch there. So let's take it out of its packaging. Ooh. Wow. That is very sleek. I love this. It's got like, I don't know if you can tell, it's thicker on this side and gets thinner. So obviously it'll have a natural little angle to it, so it doesn't hurt your wrists. Wow. I am glad I got this. This is nice. I love to have, for those of you that know me, this is no surprise, but I'm very OCD, and to have things that like look the same and look uniform and very clean is very much my thing. And I love that I have this. I have a black laptop case that's marble, and then I have this beautiful little mouse that matches my keyboard. So I will charge that up today and get that set up with my Mac and my monitor that I'm about to set up and show you guys. So we'll set this to the side right now. So beautiful. And moving on with the rest of the package, which this stuff is just boring stuff. It's like adapters to connect my laptop to the monitor, because they make these MacBooks so, even the newer ones have less like ports. So mine has an SD card port on the right side and a USB, and then this little doohickey, I don't know what this is called, a Thunderbolt port. Matthew said it's got the beveled side on it, is what it's called. I'm a danger to people with these scissors. So this little guy is also on the right side of my laptop. So that'll go in my laptop to connect to the monitor with this HDMI port on this end. And then on the left side, all I have is a headphone port, another USB port, and then my charging port. So there's very few ports in the MacBook, but I guess that's what they're going for, the minimalist look. Let's open up this guy. That was smoother. Alright, and here is the HDMI. So this will plug into my laptop, this and this will go together, and then this will go into the monitor, and it'll all be perfect. So we'll keep those together. And I'm gonna open up my monitor now, which I'm honestly so excited for. So originally I was looking on Amazon for different monitors to use, and don't need this right now. And I was, they look a lot smaller on Amazon, because I was looking at like a 27 inch monitor, and Matthew's like, that is huge. It's going to take up your entire desk. If we tried to mount it, it would be like halfway to my face, and I would have no room to like scoot up to my desk and type or write or read a book. This is heavy. And so we decided to go with the 21 and a half inch screen, and I think it'll be perfect. I've decided, I'm still waiting on my little laptop holder that holds your laptop up at eye level, so you're not having to look down. So I think I'll have that in front of me with my keyboard in front of me, and then I'll have the monitor to the side, and I'll show you guys the setup once I get it all done and set up. So let's open this bad boy up. Heard this is really easy to set up. I was reading reviews and people were like 5 minutes, so here we go. Hopefully I do this right. There's like not a lot of space in here to do this. Oh my, so many plugs. Okay, got it out of the box. Instruction manual, warranty. This is the base of the monitor. Cool, it's pretty big. Looks like Oh, probably the power cable. I have no idea what this is. No clue. Don't know what that is either. That looks really good. And I'm just, yeah, the other side of the power cable. Okay, so let's do this. Tell me in the comments what kind of people you are. Do you open up something new like this that comes clearly, probably with a step-by-step manual? Do you open it up and read the manual and then set it up? Or do you open it up and not even bother to read the manual and do what I'm doing? Honestly, I think the reason I'm not reading the manual is just because I'm so excited and I want to get this set up now, rather than having to read it and wait, because, you know, I just have enough confidence in myself that I'm smart enough to know how to do this, even though I don't know what half this stuff is. It's fine. All right. It's pretty clear to me that these two things go together. To plug into the side of the monitor, to plug into the wall for power. So I got that. I'm gonna leave these things out because I'm not sure what these are, so I'll just set those aside. Get this out. Like I said, the base. Oh! Okay. I just realized something. I think this goes in here. That's my assumption because the shapes look the same to me. So I'm assuming. Look at that. Beautiful. I'm not sure. Yeah, it comes off. I don't really know if that's supposed to like click down into there. We're just gonna go with that. And then I'm assuming the laptop somehow. Or not the laptop, the monitor somehow sits on here. Clicks on there, maybe. We shall see. Alright. First piece of styrofoam off. And here it is. Oh my gosh, it's so thin. Look how thin this is. You'll be able to tell even more when I take it out of this foam, but holy. I remember Matthew mentioning that it's thin, but this is thin. Oh my gosh, that is insane. That is so cool. All right. I figured out what that other cable is. I've seen it before, but I've never used one. The VGA. Not really sure if I'll need that. Okay, so I'm trying to do this without dropping this. So it's pretty clear that that's where this clicks in. So let's click this bad boy in here. Probably do it backwards this way. Without dropping anything. Ah. I am not sure how I'm supposed to do this. Maybe instead of manhandling the monitor, I can just do this. Okay. So it looks like I love taking off this plastic stuff, except it's not coming off very easily. Come on. Would be a lot easier, I think. Oh yes, I got it. Woo-hoo. Sweet. Okay, now I guess I could do that the same way with this. This has got a little, oh, screw that can go in a little farther. I don't know if that like attaches it to this thing more better. All right, moment of truth. Woo! It's beautiful. All right. Oh, and it even like goes back and forth a little bit. So that's pretty cool. Doesn't move this way. So I'll have to make sure I set it up the way that I want. Oh my gosh, this is going to be so nice to have for school. It'll be interesting though to see the looking here and here, but let's get this set up. Okay, got my mouse. Like I said, the RGB cable. It was RBG, for those of you that know what that means. Okay. Hopefully I have a free plug. Let's get this plugged in. I think I'm going to unplug my TV and plug that in somewhere else. Or my Apple Watch. I charge my Apple Watch at my desk, which doesn't make a lot of sense. Or does it? Woohoo! Alright. I have a meeting in 30 minutes. Okay. So I'm gonna feed this up through here. Plug it in over here. All right. She's plugged in. She looks beautiful. Now I just need to get this cord plugged into my laptop, plugged into that. So let's do that right now. Throw away all these little twist ties. Okay. I'm super excited for this. Okay, these all have those little pieces of... Oh, that's the best. This one too. Except it's like nearly impossible to find the freaking edge of it. Where are you at? And then I just end up getting impatient and like ripping it off. Ah, oh wait. Beautiful. Alrighty. Move the Yeti. Put that down here. Okay. So plug this into the side of my laptop. Alrighty, so now I have this plugged in to my laptop. So the HDMI cord will go in there and then go into the back of the monitor. So let's try it out. Moment of truth. Watch one of these cords don't fit. That'd be great. Oh, take off the little cap. For a second, I didn't think it was gonna fit because that HDMI cord looked a little big. Okay, so let's get this plugged in here. This HDMI cord is very long, but we will work with what we have. I guess too long is better than too short. Alright, now we're on the back side. Not like I'll really be looking back here anyways, but I'm trying to do this with one hand, it's hard. There we go. Alright, so now there must be a power button somewhere here. Where are you, power? Well, I can take this off. Oh, I feel like there's more to it than that. Is that all? Wow. That is tiny. Take this off too. Is I just have to tear it, I guess. Nice. Super shiny. Okay, now where is the power button? All right. Is it gonna show my my laptop's oh my god, that is amazing. It even shows like the same stuff that's on the top of my laptop. So turned my mouse off, so turn that back on, get the mouse connected. Okay, so whoa, okay. This is probably just amateur stuff, but I get really excited about this kind of stuff. My mouse is over here, and now it's over here. I don't know if you can see it. That is so cool. So this is going to be a great setup. I'll probably have either PowerPoints or Zoom over on this side, and then vice versa over here. Whatever I don't have on this side, I'll have over here. And now I'm going to set up my keyboard so that I can start typing on my keyboard. Because as soon as I have this up on the little stand, there's going to be room under it to either, to like have the keyboard under my laptop, or I can have it out here if I wanted, or if, I have to read a book or something during class, or at all, I can slide my keyboard under my laptop and then have space for my book here. But this is really awesome. I'm excited. This looks so good. Oh. What do y'all think? Let me know. All right, I have finally received my final piece of my little desk upgrade. And here it is. I'm gonna go ahead and open it now, if I can. So this last thing is the little stand for my laptop to be at the same level as my monitor, and to just help with my posture a little bit. I do find that during the day I slump a little bit, and I know that's not good for your back, so I'm hoping this will help a bit. If I can get it open. All right, here we go. So, looks like this. Pretty simple looking, at least. Instruction manual that's not in English. Oh, wow, this is heavy duty. This is like straight up metal. All right. I'm excited. Don't want to break anything. For anyone that is wanting to invest in one of these, brand is Boyata. Thank you for your purchase. It actually says, Thanks for your purchasing. It's our pleasure to meet you. Happy, would you please share your experience on Amazon? Unhappy, could you please first contact us? We'll try to solve all issues for you. That's nice. Hopefully we don't have any issues. All right. It looks pretty simple to put together. So these are the legs of it. These two pieces, and this, I'm assuming, is the thing that connects them. So, let me move my mouse out of the way. Spread these out. And I think how I do this is this piece just slides right in here. Clicks in. Beautiful. And these are like little sticky pads as well. Number two. Maybe. Woo! That one's a little bit harder. There we go. And now, here it is. I will set my laptop on here, and I will show you guys what it looks like all set up. People say we're caught up in temporary love. They say we're too young, but they don't know a thing about us.